this is vertical, 3x4. I'm going to take the exact same colors, tools, and materials and do the design horizontal for this demo. You guys at home have the creative freedom to kind of take this concept and make it your own. You know, you can put one tree in it, you can put 10 trees in it, you can do it vertically, horizontally. I leave that up to you. You will get a printed template of both of my designs, and you're welcome to copy whichever one you like verbatim, if that is what you choose. So, here's the 3x4 inch light blue background that you're all going to start with. And the first thing you're going to do is apply a powdered frit green to the base, which is going to work as the grass and the horizon line. To get these powdered frits to actually cover the blue, you're going to need to be pretty heavy-handed with it. And I'll use a hairspray as an adhesive. I have two different colored powdered frits, a dark green. I'm going to dump some into my sifter. I am going to work on top of a piece of paper, just like we've used frit in the studio. And then again, you're going to need more than you think. I'm going for about a third and a third and a third. So a third of this nightlight is going to be the grass and the horizon. A third of the nightlight is going to be the background blue color. And then the top third of the nightlight will be the leaves. And the trees are going to break these horizontal lines up nice vertically. If you find that you Then I'm going to make sure that I reclaim all of one color before I move on to the other color. Again, in an attempt not to contaminate my materials. And I'm also going to apply another little light layer of adhesive to give this a little contrast. I'm not going to put the second color everywhere. My nightlight is 3 inches high. I'm going to take my white 3-inch chunk of it. And I want to kind of casually hint at some trees being closer, some trees being farther away. Again, just like we discussed in one of our classes previously, things that are larger, more detailed, are going to feel closer, and my larger trees are also going to take up the entire space of my nightlight, whereas a few trees that are going to be in the background will be skinnier, they'll have less detail on them, and they'll start half an inch up from the bottom and end a half an inch or so below from the top to kind of give this concept of being farther away. Long, skinny lines are hard to break in glass. And the first thing I'm gonna do, is mark two or three larger-ish trees being about a quarter of an inch or so apart. And then I'm going to give myself a couple smaller-ish trees, dipping down to 3/8 of an inch, 1/8 of an inch, as skinny as I can successfully break it. give my little aspen tree bark detail to these. First, I'm going to figure out my orientation and how I want these trees. I'm going to give my aspen tree bark detail simply by gluing on little black strips of stringer. I'm gonna put more detail on the bigger foreground trees and less detail on the smaller quote unquote background trees. This stringer, it is just a long thin piece of glass. And you can break it like a piece of spaghetti. Alright, so I'm happy with that. I basically wanted them to be similar without any of them being the same. I have 2 to 3 decorative bark marks on the background trees and, you know, upwards of 7 on the closer ones. You'll notice I built this on the paper. I didn't do this on top of my blue and powdered frit background. And that's because this powdered frit grass is going to be very fragile. And anything I touch to it is going to move it around. You get a once and done chance of putting my trees onto my nightlight without kind of messing up the background. So, I have my layout here kind of pre-figured out. I'm going to glue the top 2/3 of my aspen trees. There's no point in gluing to the powdered frit. It's not a stable base. And holding this tree at the top and bottom, I'm going to place it down on top of the blue sky. And then just lightly lay it down on top of my powdered background frit. And again, once it's down, I'm just committing to it. You're not going to want to shift and adjust that after. Okay, and now I'm gonna glue on different colored frits for the leaves. Again, in an attempt to preserve our materials, I'll get rid of my contaminated workspace and come back onto a clean surface. The only thing I'm really paying attention to here is a third. I'm going to cover about the top third of this nightlight with these different kind of reds, orange, and yellows. And then I have this relatively straight line for my horizon line. And just to shake it up, I'm going to try to actively allow my leaves to not create a straight line. I think it's going to be slightly more interesting in the end. Feel free to be heavy on the glue with the frit because this does have to travel. Steps of smaller is farther away, bigger is closer up. I put my smallest frit on first, filling in the back. it should have pretty good staying power. And if you're concerned